water break.
Yeah, it's just a
canal that we're coming into now is one of the widest canals that run north and south down here in South Florida. The Everglades was also known by the Native Indians as the River of Grass. Take a look to the front right-hand side of the boat. About a 5-mile view of nothing but grass. Down at the end, I-75, also known as Alligator Alley. Most people think the Everglades is a swamp. It is not a swamp, it's a river. It's the widest, most shallow, and slowest moving river in North America. It flows from north to south at about 300 feet per day. This area that we're at now is known as Vulture Island. You might see two different types of vultures here on the island. The all black ones are known as common vultures. The ones with the red heads, they're called turkey vultures. Looks like we got some more of those lumberheads up here in the trees. Center of the island. In the mid-1800s, the vulture was the first bird ever saved from the extinction list. That one right there by the water, a couple there, right there. Surprisingly, the vulture is the cleanest bird in the Everglades. They bathe 4 to 5 times a day. Also, they have no feathers on their head. Reason for that? Well, they're eating decaying animals. They don't carry any bacteria.
Or it's just sitting there.
Thank you.
That's all clear. Over to the left-hand side of the boat up on the rocks. It's called Maiden Cane. Maiden Cane's in the bamboo family. It was used by the native Indians as the first fishing pole. And that's where they get the word cane pole that we use today. Out to hunting and fishing camps throughout the Everglades. You can take trails that look like that all the way to the west coast of Florida. Once you get further out, waters more shallow, you can find white-tailed deer and warthog.
Thank you.
About 3 feet, 3.5 feet.
It's a baby.
Got a big alligator right there in front of the boat on the levee. I'm here an alligator can go down and hold their breath for about 3 to 4 hours at a time. The warmer months of the year, they can go down and hold their breath for about an hour to an hour and a half at a time. An alligator can go through over 3,000 teeth in a lifetime. One falls out, there's always one right there to replace it.